open to me the gates of righteousness. I shall enter through them. I shall give thanks to the Lord. This is the gate of the Lord. The righteous will enter through it. I shall give thanks to thee, for thou hast answered me, and thou hast become my salvation. The stone which the builders rejected has become the chief cornerstone. This is the Lord's doing. It is marvelous in our eyes. This is the day which the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. O Lord, do save, we beseech thee. O Lord, we beseech thee, do send prosperity. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. We have blessed you from the house of the Lord. The Lord is God, and he has given us light. Bind the festival sacrifice with cords to the horns of the altar. Thou art my God, and I give thanks to thee. Thou art my God, I extol thee. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his loving kindness is everlasting. Psalms 118, 19 through 29. This is the day. This is the day the Lord has made. The Lord, today. Yesterday perhaps could claim your craft, or hopefully tomorrow, but not today, you say. This disappointing day, so filled with problems, needs, despair, and doubt. This is the day the Lord has made, and making it, he will give you strength and hope to take you through. This is the day the Lord has made, so I'll be glad and I'll rejoice in it. This is the day the Lord has made. This is the day. He delivered me from my strong enemy and from those who hated me, for they were too mighty or strong for me. Psalms 18:17. Those who hate you. Anyone who hates is very dangerous. There's no way that you can, in your own strength or by your own wisdom, defend yourself from hatred. This is because in hatred are the vibrations of everything evil. It is like the breath of hell. Even if you live thousands of miles away from the one who hates you, you can feel the evidence of evil. You can feel the evil influence of hatred when it is directed towards you. Just like you can pick up a radio station from around the world. Distance is no protection from hatred. The one who hates will send to the ends of the earth to destroy you. He is a strong enemy. Yeah, they are even too strong for you. You are defenseless against the hatred of your enemies. Yes, praise me, my beloved. I have stepped in between you and the one who hates you. I will let his hatred for you fall on me. I take all the blows that are directed at you. You need never fear. Only stay close to me so that my love can protect you from his vibrations of evil. Be very careful to never send hatred back at your enemy, for then I must also become the buffer of every attack that is directed against him by yourself. See, I cannot allow you to send arrows of hatred against anyone, not even your enemy. I came to be the great umpire, the middleman who stands between me and man and man and man. If you refuse to hate back, I will deliver you and set you in a large place, even a place of freedom and deliverance from all attacks of hatred, because I delight in you. This great large place is so remote from your enemy that there is just absolutely no way that his arrows of hatred can find your heart. There, you have full and complete protection and deliverance from every evil thing that he can plan and scheme against you. And there, you are fully blessed and used by me for my glory. Trust in the Lord and do good, so shalt thou dwell in the land, and verily thou shalt be fed. Delight thyself also in the Lord, and he shall give thee the desires of thine heart. Psalm 37, 3 and 4. My beloved one, I see you are trusting in me completely now. When you trusted in others for what they could do for you, I had to remove their support. I want you to trust in me alone. Do good to all. Always return good for evil. As you do good, you shall take possession of the land. None can move you off your inheritance. As long as the angel of the Lord does not chase you off, you are safe. You shall always be fed. You have no need to fear starvation or lack of food. I will feed you. I will bless you. I will sustain you. I will support you. You do not need to fear the hard times, for I have promised my own that in the days of famine, they shall be satisfied. My righteous ones shall never be forsaken, nor shall my seed beg for bread. Only let me be first in your life. Let all your delight be in me. Let me be your first love. Seek ye first the kingdom of God, Matthew 6:33. When you seek my will only because you love me, and when you desire only to please me, then I reciprocate and desire to give you that which is the desire of your heart. There's nothing that you can desire or hope for or even admire that I will not give you. I love you so much. You are my dearly beloved. You are my bride. Come close to me. Let me comfort you with my love. Let me comfort you with my love. Thy shall be fed.